What did I tell Mrs. Thrip? There's not a man sitting as a judge in the family division that could bear to see a woman treated in this way. Of course, I didn't know who we'd get then, did I? I'm given to believe that Mrs. Justice Appleby is the only genuine male chauvinist pig in the building. They tell me when she goes out on circuit, when she tries murders, she puts on a thin line of lipstick before summing up to the jury. It's the nearest her ladyship ever gets to the art of seduction. Oh, a frosty look at us.
Thrip versus Thrip.
And a frosty look at George. The score is love all. That must be Thrip. I must say, we could have hoped for something about twice the size. He's hardly perfect casting for the part of Bluebeard.
Yes, Mr. Rumpole.
Ready for the off. If your ladyship pleases.
Mr. Rumpole, I don't please. These long lists of grievances and complaints don't please me in the least. Is there no chance of the parties here seeing sense and coming to a reasonable compromise?
Oh, no chance whatever. This is a fight to the end, my lady. As my learned friend will assure you.
Tell her, George.
Yes, it is indeed a fight, my lady, due to last at least 6 days.
Oh, very well. Tell me about it, Mr. Rumpole.
This is probably one of the strangest cases this court may ever have heard. The story of a Bluebeard who kept his wife a virtual prisoner in their flat at Muswell Hill, denied her the simple comforts of biscuits and bathwater, denied her the comforts of his conversation, but communicated with her only by means of brusque, bitter, and insulting little notes.
Mr. Rumpole.
Yes, my lady.
May I remind you of something?
Certainly, my lady.
The jury box is empty. This is a trial by judge alone. I don't require to be swayed by your oratory, which no doubt is enormously effective in criminal cases. Just give me the relevant dates, will you?
Yes. Lady, you and your so-called son can be off to your mother's in Ryslip. Let her pay for the light you leave blazing in the toilet.
That was pinned up on my kitchen cupboard.
Your kitchen cupboard.
Just a moment, Mr. Rumpole. Very well.
Now then, Mrs. Thrip. What was the effect upon you of this heartbreaking notice to quit?
She stayed for more, apparently.
If your ladyship pleases.
You didn't go, did you?
Perhaps she was afraid to, my lady.
Oh, really, my lady, my learned friend mustn't lead.
Oh, do relax, George. Stop going up and down like a yo-yo.
It's true, I just didn't know what
Speak
my husband would do.
Speak more slowly, please.
More slowly, please, Mrs. Thrip.
I just didn't know what my husband would do if I left him.
But what sort of thing did you fear he might do?
I just didn't know.
Mrs. Thrip, you put up with this intolerable conduct from your husband for 3 years. Why exactly?
I suppose I was sorry for him.
Sorry for him? Why?
I thought he'd never manage on his own.
Mr. Thrip, is there anything in your conduct to your wife of which you are thoroughly ashamed? Good question, that. If he says yes, he's made a damaging admission. If he says no, he's a self-satisfied idiot.
No.
He's a self-satisfied idiot.
Really, Mr. Thrip? You have behaved absolutely perfectly.
Exactly. My point, I think. 15 love, first game, second set. I'm going out to my Masonic ladies' night. It's a pity I haven't got a lady to take with me. Is that the way a perfect husband behaves?
Perhaps not.
Or was that the cruelest, unkindest cut of all?
Well, I was annoyed with her.
Annoyed? You wrote these bitter words out of mere annoyance?
Well, I had asked her to the ladies' night.
Asked her?
I left a note for her, naturally.
Oh, naturally.
Mr. Rumpole, will you ask the witness to speak up?
Would you speak up, please, Mr. Thrip?
I left a note for her, naturally.
Naturally, yes. You couldn't do anything so human as to actually speak with her.
She didn't reply.
Oh, Well, I'm not surprised getting an invitation like this. Mr. Thrip, did you actually want your wife to accompany you to the Masonic Ladies' Night?
Oh, yes, indeed.
What? This termagant who overfills your baths, refuses to wash your shirts. You were actually looking forward to spending a pleasant evening with her.
Well, I had no one else to go with.
Ah, and would rather go with her than no one.
Of course I would. She's my wife, isn't she?
Mr. Thrip, I suggest that all these charges against your wife are quite untrue.
They're not untrue.
But you wanted her to go with you. You just said so. You wanted to flaunt her on your arm at the Café Royal. Why? Well, come, Mr. Thrip, answer the question. It can't possibly be because you love her.
Yes. I do.
Do what, Mr. Thrip?
Do love.
Oh, Rumpole, Rumpole.
Mr. Rumpole.
Have you asked one question too many? Yes, Your Ladyship.
Is it really too late for common sense to prevail?
Common sense, my lady?
Could there not be one final attempt at a reconciliation?
George, I feel our precious divorce slipping away from us.
I have no power to order this, of course, but it does seem to me that Mr. and Mrs. Thrip might meet perhaps in counsel's chambers simply to explore the possibilities of a reconciliation. There is one very important consideration, of course, and I refer to young Norman Thrip, the child of the family. I shall adjourn now until tomorrow morning.
Be upstanding.